Now, there are some who have a different view, as you all know. They seek an international legal instrument that would lead to exclusive government control over internet resources, institutions, and content, and national barriers on the free flow of information online. But this, in our view, would lead to a fragmented internet, one that does not connect people but divides them, a stagnant cyberspace, not an innovative one, and ultimately a less secure cyberspace with less trust among nations. They should not be prevented from sharing their innovations with global consumers simply because they live across a national frontier. That's not how the internet should ever work, in our view. Not if we want it to remain the space where economic, political, and social exchanges can flourish. We have an expression in our country: if it ain't broke, don't fix it. It would be misguided, in our view, to break with the system that has worked so well for so long. The digital marketplace of ideas that welcomes every blog and tweet is the same one that inspires the next generation of innovators to fuel our economies. And when businesses consider investing in a country with a poor record on internet freedom, and they know that their website could be shut down suddenly, their transactions monitored, their staffs harassed, they'll look for opportunities elsewhere.